Hi everybody, this is now our introduction to mixed numbers. And first you need to know, what is a mixed number? Sometimes we have improper fractions, which we talked about in the previous module. And improper fractions means that the bottom number is smaller or equal to the top number, which is our numerator. So there's a different way that we can write the fractions, and we use mixed numbers. Mixed meaning it's a combination of a whole number and a fraction. So in this little demonstration right here, the little figure, it shows there are two ovals, and with the two ovals, each one is cut into two parts. Three out of those parts are shaded, so that means that would be three shaded over two. Two represents the denominator, which is how many one of the pieces is broken into. All right, on the next slide, when you see this one, you look at part A and you have six ovals, and each one of those is divided into two equal parts. So your denominator for your improper fraction will be two. Then you ask yourself how many of those pieces are shaded, and you see there are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 out of those shaded. So your improper fraction would be 11 divided by 2, and then we're going to change that to a mixed number in just a minute. For the bottom part, you will notice that each one of those parallelograms is divided into 5 equal parts, and there are 6 pieces out of 5 shaded, so that would be 6 divided by 5. Now on the next slide, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how to change a mixed number to an improper fraction, and then we're going to change an improper fraction into a mixed number. Again, all of these notes are worked out for you, and I'm going to work a couple of examples, which would be these two right here, to change each mixed number into an improper fraction. There are a couple of steps that we need to do, so I'm going to go to the board and talk about those. Okay, so the first piece that we have is 2 1/4. That means two whole pieces plus 1 out of 4 of another. So to change this mixed number into an improper fraction, there are a couple of things that we do. The first step that we do is to take our denominator, and we are going to multiply it to the whole number. So we multiply the denominator to the whole number, which would make 8. And then we add the numerator. Okay, so you multiply the denominator by the whole number, and that makes 8. And then you take that and you add the numerator, which makes 9. So that would be 9 pieces out of 4, because your denominator just slides over. 9 pieces out of 4, that would be shaded. Okay, let's do the next one. I'll write it a little closer. All right, we take our denominator 5, and we are going to multiply 5 times 4, which makes 20. And then we add the numerator, which is 3, so that makes 23 out of 5, because the denominator slides over. So anytime you want to take a mixed number, no matter how big or small it is, to turn it to an improper fraction, multiply the denominator to the whole number, and then you add the numerator, okay? And then the denominator stays the same, it just slides across. All right, now, let's say that you wanna do the opposite. I give you an improper fraction, and I want you to change that into a mixed number. So here's what you do. We do the opposite. When we were trying to go from mixed numbers to improper fractions, we did multiplication first. So when we do the opposite, we're going to do division first, because that's how we undo this. So I'm going to take the fraction 13/5, and I'm going to rewrite this as a division problem. So when you rewrite this as division, the denominator goes on the outside. That becomes your divisor. Remember the vocabulary from one of the earlier modules. And the numerator, the 13, becomes the dividend, right? Because that's what you divide into. So we say, how many times does 5 divide into 13? It goes in there 2 times, which would make 2 times 5 makes 10. And then we subtract. And when we subtract, we will have a remainder. So when we have the remainder, this remainder becomes the numerator. How many times it went into there? 2 is the whole number. And again, your denominator is going to stay the same. So 13 divided by 5, because that's what your fraction bar means, is division, is now the mixed number 2 3/5. Okay? So now let's do the other one. I'm going to erase some of this over here to give us some more room. We have the fraction 7/2. That means 7 divided into 2 parts. So we're going to take our denominator goes outside, the numerator goes inside, and you divide. How many times does 2 divide into 7? 3 times. And then we multiply. 3 times 2 makes 6. And then we're going to subtract, and that leaves us 1. So this is our numerator. The 3 is our whole number. So our mixed number will look like this. 3 1/2. The denominator will stay the same no matter what it is. Okay? All right. That is all we have for that lesson. And when we come back, we will be learning more about fractions.